Good evening. My name is Frank Anocha Abuaje from Church of God, Ghana. I'd like to share a very simple message with you this evening. And let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, we pray, committing ourselves into your hand. Father, may we be led by your Spirit. Father, help us to be doers of your word and not hearers of your word. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. May God bless you. We thank God Almighty and we thank the organizers of this program. May God bless you for your time and for your plans to lift the future generation of the called and chosen. I'd like to share a very simple message with you, as I said. And the title of my message is True Worshippers, True Worshippers, True Worshippers. You need to be a true worshipper of God. The Bible makes us understand in the book of John that many years ago in Judea, when Christ came to discover that the Pharisees knew that he was baptizing more disciples than John the Baptist. When Christ knew that he departed from Judea to Galilee, and moving from Judea to Galilee, Christ decided to pass through Samaria. In passing through Samaria, she met the Samaritan woman. Christ decided to bring the Samaritan woman to a point of salvation. And in doing that, Christ discovered that the lady was limited in the area of worship. He was limited in the area of the gospel. So Christ told her in John chapter 4, verse 23, that the hour is coming and it's now here where the true worshipers are worship the Father in truth and in spirit. For the Father seeks such people to worship him. I repeat, John chapter 4, verse 23. The hour is coming and it's now here when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in truth and in spirit. In truth and in spirit. For the Father seeks such people to worship him. Out of the called, the Father chooses. The Bible said, many are called, but few are chosen. But out of the chosen, the Father also expect us to be true worshipers of the gospel, to be true worshipers as his children. The Bible said, for his spirit and our spirit bear witness that we are children of God. So it is the spirit that bears witness with his spirit that we are children of God. So in this dispensation, the level and the standard of which Christ expects us to live should be in the area of spirituality. No matter how well you preach, no matter how well you prophesy, no matter how well you are gifted, no matter how well you sing and your talent, the Bible is saying you need to be a true worshiper. And the requirements and the standard of a true worshiper is to worship God in truth and in spirit. You can't live one and maintain one. You can't be spiritual and be disloyal to God. You can't be a truthful person and live in carnality. So the Bible said, true worshippers shall worship God in truth and in spirit. Even the Muslim knows the truth. Even the Buddhist know the truth. Even carnal people know the truth. It takes the level of spirituality for you to please God. Although God said by faith you are going to please him in Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6. In this dispensation of the Holy Spirit, if you want to operate in the level and in the standard of spirituality, operating in the level and the highest rank of pleasing God, you need to operate in the area of spirituality and in truth. You need to combine these two. For the Bible says, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. You cannot be spiritual and begin to tell lies. You cannot be spiritual and begin to do anything that you like. The Bible makes us understand true worshippers. That is the question for you. Are you a true worshipper, Bishop? Are you a true worshipper, Madam Singer? Are you a true worshipper, an usher? You need to be a true worshipper as a Christian, because true worshippers shall worship the Father in truth and in spirit. You might be worshiping God, but the question is, are you worshiping God in truth and in spirit? Are you worshiping the Father in truth and in spirit? You need to be a true worshiper. You need to be a true worshiper as a Christian, because these are the people the Father is seeking. Many people are seeking the Father, but the Father is also seeking some people, and these people are true worshipers. The time is now here. When true worshipers shall worship God in truth and in spirit. It's a question for you. Are you worshiping God in truth and in spirit? I pray for you. May you worship God in truth and in spirit. May you stay out of sin and live a holy life. Because in this dispensation of the Holy Spirit, it is only spirituality and truth that will cause you to be a true worshiper. Maybe God has called you. God has chosen you. But aside being chosen, you need to be a true worshiper. May God bless you and stay as a true worshiper in the kingdom of God. May God bless you for your time. In Jesus' name, amen.